continue from where we have been in our discussion we are onto. Already we know that verb group of do
is also one of the groups we find under primary auxiliary verbs. Our main target now is to see how they function to mean auxiliary
in our different sentential constructions. Starting with do, somebody would say, I do go to school.
I do go to school. This is auxiliary, and this is our word, main verb.
So in this context, you call it auxiliary, and this is our main verb. For does, you now say, he does
go to school. Does here is our auxiliary, while go still answers our
main verb. Okay, now, what differentiates between do and does? This is another thing that is given much or many writers or speakers of English language a very big time. They prove to be very problematic for users of English language in terms of writing or speaking. Do you know that as we have singular nouns and plural nouns,
such cases like boy is singular, boys with the addition of S inflectional morphemic item changes boy from being singular to plural. Thus we have these cases that you know, we have also the same case regarding discussion on what verbs are.
Many people do not even know or understand that verbs can either be singular and can also be what? Plural. I've given you such cases of is and was. Is is singular. Was is also singular. One present and the other one past. We have are and were. Are is plural. While were is what? Also plural. But one is present and the other one is past. Okay, coming back to this one, verb group of do. We have do. We have does.
Do is plural, while does is what? Singular. Somebody will say, ah, why is it so? When we have es, it's supposed to be plural. Thus, for instance, now we have mango, and the plural form is what? Mangoes. Okay? Somebody may have the same notion that when we add s or es or ies to a noun, we are removing it from being singular to plural. Yes, that is only for now. Like we have
lorry, this Y changes to what? I-E-S to mean lorries. This is singular, and this is what? Plural. But this only is the case of what we call noun. The reverse is the case for verbs. Any verb that takes S or ES
or IES, it is not a plural form of a verb, but a singular form of a verb. For instance, do is not singular, but what? Plural. The singular form is what? Does. This is the singular form. Unlike what you have for boy, taking s to mean plural. If a particular verb takes s, it becomes singular. For instance, speak is plural. Speaks is the singular. Can you see how the change in the variation of what you determine for pluralization
of nouns wouldn't actually be accommodated in the pluralization of what? Verbs. You have to be very, very careful. Okay, now, I do go to school, or let me just make it,
we do go to school. We here is a plural subject, and it has to go with what? Do, which is a plural verb. And here, under the capacity of what we call auxiliary, don't forget, this is auxiliary, and it is helping the main verb which is go. He does go to school. Does to is auxiliary and singular. And this is why it goes with this singular subject, singular word subject, which is he. So you cannot say we does go to school, and you cannot say he do go to school. In that case, we say you do not know the grammar or the rule of speaking English language. Okay, now we've given examples for do and does, and we've seen how they operate as what? As auxiliary verbs, as they
all help what? The girl, which is the main verbs in the chosen sentences. Let's see that of did and that of what? Done. For instance, somebody would make a sentence this way.
I did go to school. For instance, somebody would ask you, did you go to school today?
You say, yes, I did go to school. Don't say, I did went to school. That is very, very wrong.
I did went to school is not a correct English. This is the correct one. Because
once there is a kind of a typification of the fact that the sentence is reflecting the past already assumed with the use of the auxiliary verb, the main verb shouldn't just be also in the past. It should maintain its own root form. So this is the correct sentence, while this one is what? Wrong.
Did here is our auxiliary, okay? This is our auxiliary and this is our main verb. So I did go to school is having how many verbs? We have two verbs, did and go. So did is auxiliary,
while go is what? Main verb. Okay, now do we give another example? Yes, we did. We did eat the food. We did eat the food. Somebody may have asked you, did you eat the food? You say, yes, we did eat the food.
Did here is our auxiliary, while eat here is our main verb. So you can see how we use them to function as auxiliary verbs
by giving assistance grammatically to what we have as our main verb. The last item in this category is what? Is done. And let's see how we can use done to show our auxiliary effect of its own use. Somebody would say,
I am done slacking. I am done slapping the man. I am done slapping the man.
How many verbs do we have here? Or rather, how many verbs do we have? There are three verbs. Are they all main verbs? No. Are they all auxiliary verbs? No. I told you, the last one should be the main verb. And this will tell you that we have am auxiliary. And don't forget, we use am under primary auxiliary verb and under verb group of be. Therefore, done here is verb group of do, which is also
one auxiliary. And slapping here is our main verb because it is the organ, the precedent of this particular conglomeration of the verbs or the verb phrase.
Are we there? Okay, I think with this, we are good to go in our understanding of auxiliary verbs, primary auxiliary verbs, and that verb group of words, do. But still, I want to leave you with this. You can still contextualize them.
They can be contextualized not to answer their original names as auxiliaries, but to answer what we call main verbs. For instance, you can say, I am a student. No, we are not supposed to use am, sorry. You can say, I do it. I do it. I here is our subject, do here is our verb, and it is the only verb. It here is our object. So is do our auxiliary verb? No, it is not auxiliary. Because how it is contextualized here simply refers it to be called what? To be called main verb. So you see, it is not all time you see auxiliary verb by concluding that it is auxiliary. First, you have to find out how many verbs do we have. If it is two, then it is auxiliary and the other one is main. If there are three, the first two are auxiliaries and the last one is main. But if it is only one, whether you know it as auxiliary or whatever, if it is just one single verb in that sentence, you conclude by saying it is a main verb. Just as I have given you an example here. Somebody would say,
I did the work. I did the work. In this sentence too, there is only one verb. And what is that? Did.
Don't say I is a verb. It is subject, which is a pronoun. And the whole of this, the work, is our object. So did here is our only verb. And you know it has been auxiliary. But in this context, it is simply to say it is contextualized here to mean
it is the only main verb we have in the sentence. So as students of English, as learners of English like me, you have to be very, very considerate. Do not conclude by saying anytime you see them, they are auxiliaries. Context can grant them the name to be called what? Main verbs. Let's see the last one, which is verb group of have. You can join me so that we continue.